Get ready to match the stars. Chucky Green. Brett Summers. Gary Berghoff. Elaine Joyce. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rivers.
Thank you, Johnny O, and thank you, friend. Well, everybody's all riled up there. You ready? We're not going to start until you're ready. You guys ready over here? One and two? Three's ready.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, well, she's ready.
What are those, caramels?
No, those are busted buttons is what they're glued on there. I'm all glued together. Are you all right? Is everyone all right?
Oh, sure. No, but I'm all glued together.
Compared to who?
No, sweetheart, no.
I feel very undressed, sir.
Is that the real you?
Yes, but I mean, if I was supposed to wear a jacket, I feel very bad because I didn't bring a jacket this year.
He was supposed to wear a jacket, wasn't he?
He should have worn a jacket.
Yeah. How come you didn't wear a jacket, Checky?
I didn't have a jacket, that's why.
Yes. You don't have a jacket?
No.
Oh.
We'll take up a collection.
Will someone give Checky a jacket?
Maybe if he had a nice evening dress.
Yes.
An evening dress would be fine.
Down! Down!
I won't be able to write now.
That's funny. I borrowed it from John Wayne.
You didn't have to tell me a thing like that, kid.
All right, now you sit down there. And we're all going to say hello to our two players here, Pat Schrott and Sandy Jasek. How are you, ladies? This is our current champion. She's won a pretty good bundle of money, $5,800, right?
Yes.
And she's being challenged by Sandy. And she's had her second round question. She has four. You have four. And when you get your question, all you need is one to win your third game. Yes, right. And we'll see if that happens right after we see about this little message. Okay, here we go. I'll push this button. I have this question for Pat Schrott. Remember, all you need is one to win. Listen carefully. Who does not...
I don't play.
Let's see. This
Frick
is just for
frack.
Betty and Elaine. Frick and Frack are the only two participating. All right, ladies.
Frick or Frack.
At the restaurant, Gertrude said to the waiter, "Is this chicken fresh?" And the waiter said, "Lady, if it were any fresher, it would blank." At the restaurant, Gertrude said to the waiter, "Is this chicken fresh?" And the waiter said, "Lady, if it were any fresher, it would blank." If it were any fresher, it would blank. You finished.
No, that's wrong.
That's all right.
Because I know why.
Good answer.
I don't want to hear that.
I have a question. Is this a chicken joke?
No, this is not a chicken joke.
Who was that?
I didn't think so.
All right, here we go. This is for Pat Schrott. At the restaurant, Gertrude said to the waiter, "Is this chicken fresh?" And the waiter said, "Lady, if it were any fresher, it would blank."
Cluck.
It would cluck. One cluck wins the game. Do you cluck, lady?
Not necessarily. Lay an egg, I said.
She said lay an egg.
Would cluck.
Is that your second choice, Pat?
It was clucking while it laid the egg.
It could have been. One never knows, because sometimes it's painful. What do you say?
Sometimes you show your answer, Betty.
Lay an egg with a cluck.
That's
no,
right.
Listen, this may call for a meeting.
A meeting?
We may have to have
Let's
a meeting.
Have a meeting.
Because cluck and quack, 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 quack.
What's cackle?
Cackle.
There's another $100 for you. Stand by for a moment. Have to say goodbye to you. You what?
Tell Shecky I expect the money.
Shecky, she expects the money in the mail there.
You wait till after the show and I'll get you the money. I feel terrible.
Listen, we've got
Sandy.
A gift for you together with our thanks for being with us here on Match Game 75. It was a pleasure meeting you, Sandy. Goodbye. All right. There goes Sandy. You know, it isn't often you meet a lady with a 21-inch waist, and that's what she has. She's a very attractive lady, and so are you, and you're richer by $100. You're now up to $5,900, and you're going to have a go at over $5,000 here. You ready?
I'm ready.
We polled a recent studio audience. We got their best response to this. Ship blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500. You match an extra and you get $250. If you match a third, you get $100. Whom do you call on?
Betty White.
Betty White.
Oh, dear. Ship ahoy.
Ship ahoy. There's one.
Richard.
Richard, have you got one?
Shipwreck.
Shipwreck.
Elaine. Ship shape.
Ship shape. Well, you got three good ones there, but you may think of a better one. What do you want to do here?
I like shipwreck.
You like shipwreck. All right. That's the one that Richard gave you. Find out if it's up there, and if so, where. Hold everything, because there's a little funny noise here. Where is that noise coming from?
From your mic.
From my microphone. Well, now, let me just fix it.
Isn't it embarrassing when your tummy growls like that?
Is it all right? Hello, testing, 1, 2, 3, blah, 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 blah. Okay, all right. I will hold it very delicately.
Hold the mic carefully, too.
Yeah. Except when I hold it like this, I talk funny. I'm only kidding. There's my deep voice. Now, what are we looking for
Charles
here?
Charles Nelson Reilly, honey.
Shipwreck. Is it under the $100 response, I ask you? No, it is not. That's your answer. Ship shape. The one Elaine gave you? All right. Shipwreck. Here it is. Is it under the $250 response? Yes, it is, indeed. Congratulations.
Ship ahoy.
Ship ahoy?
Okay.
What do you think? Ship ahoy?
Ship ahoy!
Ship ahoy.
Shipmate.
Shipmate. Oh, shipmate.
Shipmate.
No. All right. Here's a $500 response, just for the heck of it. Ship ahoy. Ahoy, ahoy. That's what Betty gave you.
What's
that? A
lot of sailors in the audience.
Are there a lot of sailors in the audience? What's that? Oh, the day they gave. Oh, I see. Okay, so you've got the $250. Now you're going to play for $2,500. Remember to collect that. You've got to match one of them head-to-head, and this will have to be an exact match. Which one do you choose?
I'm going to take Betty again.
I've taken Betty there. I'm sorry. She's taken. No, Betty, you get
ready to write. You've had her, not taken her.
Okay.
Labramas, that'll be all over town.
I don't know what to say.
Very nervous. All right, here we go. Betty, you get set to write. Here's the $2,500 question. Blank boots. B-O-O-T-S. Blank boots. Or blank boots. All right, now she's finished, and we want you to give us an answer which you think will match hers. What's your judgment here, Pat? Blank boots.
I thought of so many, but I'm going to say puss in boots.
You say puss in boots. Are there a lot of good ones?
Rain boots.
Yeah, there are a lot of good ones here, but you
but
say...
she's an animal lover.
She's an animal lover, so you think she said puss in boots, all right. For $2,500, may we see your answer, please?
Oh, honey, I wish I had. I am an animal lover, but I said cowboy boots.
Cowboy boots.
I'm so sorry.
Can we go back to Ahoy?
I'm sorry.
Okay, so, Pat, you've got the $6,150, and you're going to meet another player in a moment or so. But right now, got a little business for you. Here it is, friends. Yes, good. Okay. Now, Pat, if you're set and ready to play another game, we'll present another player. Let's all welcome Terry Cluck. Hi, Terry.
Hi.
How are you?
Fine.
Good. Terry, where were you when we needed you?
Clucking back there.
You were clucking back there? Where does Terry Cluck live and all that?
I live in San Diego, California.
Yeah.
With my husband, Bob, who's in the audience. And we have two little girls, Jennifer and Amber, and two dogs.
What kind of dogs have you got?
Well, a poodle and the other is kind of a mixture.
That's nice. They're
Polly
smart,
Shepherd.
Those mixtures.
You bet they are.
All those mixtures are very smart. All right, are you ready to play?
As ready as I'll ever be.
Okay. Let's play then. Terry, please make a selection.
A.
All right. New game. Everybody plays.
Okay.
Zsa Zsa said, do you do Zsa Zsa? Who does Zsa Zsa?
Darling,
Zsa said.
Darling, my new husband is a real practical joker. During our wedding reception, he glued my blanks together.
Let's get Shecky to do his imitation of Zsa. Almost anything would be better.
Oh, thanks a lot.
Darling.
No.
Darling.
I don't think I can do Zsa.
You don't do Zsa.
No, I don't do Zsa.
Darling.
No.
What's the matter with you, darling?
I never do my
Why don't you do Zsa? You do Zsa. You don't do Zsa. Do you do Zsa?
No, but most everyone else
does. Most everyone else has done Zsa.
I do the other Hungarian. What was S.C. Segal? Remember S.C. Segal, who was Hungarian?
Yes. I want to say, remember that one?
Yes, I do remember.
Nobody else remember that one.
What was it again?
Listen, you're not supposed to listen to all this funny stuff. You're supposed to be right in here.
What was the question?
Darling, my new husband is a real practical joker. During our wedding reception, he glued my blanks together, darling. Now, there are a number of good choices here. Don't think so hard. You're going to strain something.
Oh, well, don't rush me. You'll be sorry.
Oh, I can't say that one.
Dude, you're mumbling, Shecky. All right. I just put...
Are you... I'll be all right.
Are you all right?
Yeah.
What are you trying to do?
I'll be all right, yeah.
Oh, okay.
There we go. Wait.
Slot there.
Don't
be nervous. We'll make a star out of you yet. Now, just put it in a slot there.
My light
don't go on. Okay, now, here we go. Terry. Zsa said, darling, my new husband is a real practical joker. During our wedding reception, he glued my blanks together.
Boobies.
He said, you heard what she said.
I'm
not going to say it. Go ahead.
I'll tell you the truth. I wanted to say that, but I wanted to. This is my first time on the show, and I didn't want to be disliked. So I said rings.
Rings. Well, now, she does wear a lot of rings, and her mother's in the jewelry business right. And all that. All right, Brett.
This actually could be termed a euphemism.
A euphemism?
Yes, or something of that.
That third,
stones.
Yeah. Stones?
How okay. About stones?
No, no.
How about dead drunk?
Leave that lady alone now. You be kind to her. She's over 29 years old.
Almost.
Hey, Gary.
If I had those roots, I wouldn't talk about
that. Uh-oh. There. Hide! Stones and rocks so far. I don't know. It sounds like she's got a kidney condition. What have you seen?
It's funny.
Yes. He glued my blanks together.
Well, this guy was really a practical joker, and he glued her ex-husbands together.
There's a good answer. That's a
and
good,
it was an
good.
Orgy.
Yes. That's lovely. Lovely answer.
Thank you.
Beautiful.
Thank
all
you.
Right.
You're so sweet.
Late end and her husband could reach from here to Barstow.
I was only saying before the show to the fourth funniest man in America, Mr. Shecky Green, I said, one of these days, the word boobs will come up.
Okay. Now, Miss Betty White, honey, from...
Well, I can have just as much fun as anybody, but I do think there's a time and a place. Her boobs together.
Two for you. Two for you.
She got two.
Yes, of course. I went over and said two for you. She says, I've got two. Don't bother me. So that's two for her. And
tea
for two.
Right.
Jacques Cousteau, the famous scuba diver.
Oh, yeah.
She said.
You've been underwater too long.
He said, tonight is the grand costume ball, and I know just what to wear. I will pump my wetsuit full of air, and I will go as blank. He said that, then he gave a little jocular laugh after he says, oh, you know how the Frenchmen are.
That's a very good Jacques Cabour.
Jacques Cousteau said tonight is the grand costume ball and I know just what to wear. I will pump my wetsuit full of air and I will go as blank there.
Okay.
All right. What's that? You go as a blank? No, it said just go as blank. That's all it says here. You do not remember you wrote the question and you forgot so soon what it says here? He's, Mal de Mer, the producer. No, you can't. Gary, what are you doing? I'm going to throw you back in the tank.
Sorry.
All right, Pat. Tonight is the Jacques Cousteau, you know who she is. Tonight is the grand costume ball, and I know just what to wear. I will pump my wetsuit full of air, and I will go as blank.
Another Jacques Gleason.
Jackie Gleason. Oh, because he is a big
That's
one,
funny
huh?
In the question.
Yes. But,
Pardon, the audience.
I pump my wetsuit full of air and he goes a penguin. No, what's
Watch it now, no. I told you for the last time.
Jackie Gleason.
You know how I am with aquariums. As a blowfish.
A blowfish.
Of course.
Oh, yes. Blowfish. She say blowfish.
Don't tell me.
What do you mean, she?
She?
Jackie saw me.
Little girl, what do you say?
I say if the shoe fits,
I said,
put it on.
Wait a minute, it's my turn.
That's right.
I said that he blew it up and it got huge, enormous, right? And he went as a submarine.
As a submarine?
A submarine,
yes. She is looking
so far,
for a Jackie Gleason. All right, sir, what do you say?
I know Jacqueline Cousteau quite well.
Oh, yes.
Jacqueline?
You know he dives with all of his men. He has a white... suit.
White wetsuit.
He blow it up.
We
go to the ball.
We
as Moby Dick.
Moby Dick. Very good. Very good. The little lady on the end.
I'm afraid I blew it. A balloon.
A balloon. Well, I'm sorry we got no Jackie Gleason's for you. So there's the end of round one, and the score is 2-0 in favor of Terry. And now this message for you, then you come right back for round two. Here we go to round two. Okay, Terry?
B, please.
B. All right. Richard and Betty do not participate. Everyone else does. Y'all remember Fanny Fox, the Argentinian bombshell?
Yes.
Okay. Well...
She's going into the history books, and don't you forget it.
Yes. Now, let me go on with this, if you would, please. Wilbur Mills just got an important job in Washington. Now, she's Fanny Fox, the blanker of the house. Wilbur Mills just got her, Fanny Fox, a job in Washington, and now she's Fanny Fox, the blanker of the house.
I love it when I get the answer.
You got it right away. All right. No. Anything you say.
Anything you
say. All right.
Anything.
Finished. Okay, now we're all set. Terry Clark. Fanny Fox, the Argentinian bombshell. Do you remember her? She was in the newspapers and all that. Wilbur Mills just got her an important job in Washington. Now she's known as Fanny Fox, the blanker of the house.
Streaker.
The streaker of the house. She got it. She got it.
Okay, mine rhymes with streaker, it's speaker.
The speaker
but
of the
really
house.
But I really wanted to, you want to know something?
What?
What does that mean? Is it recess?
No.
In a way, it's recess.
I wanted to really say what she said, but I didn't say it.
You didn't say it. You thought of it and rejected it.
Yeah, I don't know
Trust your
I
first just, impulse.
I don't know
I
why.
Love
Trust your first impulse,
lips.
Yes.
I'm beginning to hate myself.
All right, Brett.
Well... Is this a match? I said the stripper of the house.
The stripper of the house does not match streaker of the house. Gary, what have you got?
The streaker of the house.
The streaker of the house. There's one for you. And here she is.
Guess what? Guess what?
The blonde bombshell.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, I did.
Streaker. Well, you did. All right, that's four for you.
Okay. Now you stand by for a moment or so. It's 4-0 at this moment, and we'll get to your question later. Now this. Now, Terry and Pat, we've got to stop right here. I'm sorry to do it in the middle of the second and final round, but that's the way it is. Our time is up, and we'll look forward to seeing both of you next time. Score is 4-0 in favor of our challenger, Terry Cluck.
Terry.
Now, what was I going to ask you? Oh, you're in thing that's coming
up. She's a cop.
Police story.
Oh, yes. Is that going to play soon?
Yes, it's going to be on this month.
Police story.
Police story.
What do you play?
I play a doctor.
You play a doctor?
Yes, that's why I cut my
hair. Are you the doctor?
I'm getting the vapors. I think I'm feeling sick.
I'm just taking a turn for the nurse.
She's a doctor, not a nurse.
Oh,
there.
He's spaghetti.
Is there anything, any other service we can perform? You're going to be at the Fountain Blow in Florida.
Fountain Blow in Florida.
Fountain Blow.
Miami
yes,
Beach.
Yes, and my husband's opening at the Winter Garden Theater in New York in Dr. Jazz.
That's a musical
yes.
comedy
yes.
on Broadway.
Terrific.
We wish him well.
And
you,
my
sir.
Wife isn't working. Skim
my pool tomorrow about 10.
Okay. Gene Rayburn, Match Game 75. Join us next time. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 75, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of the CBS stations.